So Paul Hughes is the director of Vivation International, and he teaches people around the world in this technique of vivation. And what I found so interesting when I went to his workshop was how different the focus is in this kind of circular breathing practice to most of the other more intense circular breathing practices, where there's a much greater focus on awareness and feeling and breathing with each feeling. And I found that really interesting from my own work as a meditation teacher around the idea of acceptance and dropping resistance. Yeah, so just a really complete philosophy on breathing. And he very kindly agreed to lead me in a 10-minute practice that you can check out and try for yourself. So I'm in the background of this video doing it with you. I'm there in spirit. And if you find it interesting, then do check out my full interview with Paul, where we talk about the history of this technique, how he got into it, all the philosophy behind it. Really interesting video, so definitely check that out. And of course, if you like the video, do give it a like. And if you want to subscribe to the channel, I'm releasing new videos, interactive videos like this and interviews every week. So definitely check those out. All right, enjoy. Trigger warning. This recording includes the sound of heavy breathing. Health warning. This recording suggests a circular breathing rhythm. Circular breathing should not be practiced if you are pregnant or think that you may be, have high blood pressure or heart disease, have post-traumatic stress disorder or a history of psychosis, have undergone recent surgery or experienced a recent injury, suffer from epilepsy, have clinical anxiety or suffer from panic attacks, or have glaucoma, eye pressure. Disclaimer: conscious breathing exercises can induce strong mental and somatic experiences. You may experience powerful effects, including surges of emotion, bodily tingling, increased heart rate, and muscle contractions. The prompts in this recording are suggestions only. You are responsible for yourself. Listen to your own body. Trust your own experience and stop immediately if you feel unsure or unwell. If you have any physical or mental health concerns, consult your medical professional before engaging in any conscious breathing practices. Conscious breathing techniques should never be practiced whilst driving or operating heavy machinery. The instructions in this video are not to be taken as medical advice. This channel, its creators, its partners, and its featured speakers accept no liability for adverse reactions. All rapid breathing practices can stimulate the sympathetic branch of the autonomic nervous system. This energetic stimulation can be experienced as anxiety. If you already have anxiety, I recommend watching the videos on this channel about coherent breathing instead.
So everybody, just go ahead and close your eyes. Take a couple of big, deep breaths. And on the exhale, just let it go. Don't force it out. Don't slow it down. Just allow it to take whatever time it needs on the exhale. So it's a complete, it's like when you play dead, you just collapse. Every exhale should just be a complete surrender. So we'll do another one in, big inhale. And let it go. And what we're doing here is circular breathing. The idea is that as you're breathing, and I want you to keep doing it, is there is essentially no pauses between the inhales or the exhales. So inhale, when you can't get any more air, exhale, and just allow the exhale to complete before taking your next inhale in. And for now, we'll just breathe full and slow. And generally what I'd like you to do is to breathe in as much air as you can comfortably on the inhale. Breathe more than you would normally is the idea. And one of the tricks you can do if you are laying down is you could put a book on your stomach to make sure that you're doing diaphragmatic breathing. So as you inhale, your stomach should go out, the book should go up, and on the exhale, should go down. And if you want to get even more air as the book goes up and your stomach goes out, you can top it off in your chest, even a little bit more at the top. So you can do your belly breathing and then top it off with chest breathing, 10-15% more, and then exhale. And that way you get a really complete inhale. And we'll just do this for another 30 seconds or so. And I just want you to notice now what this moment feels like. Notice that you're at least feeling the pressure of the chair or surface that you're laying on. Or you might be noticing some pattern of energy, sensation, or feeling somewhere in your body. The idea is, as you're doing this circular breathing, scan through your entire feeling awareness from the top of your head to the tips of your fingers and toes. And notice any feeling or sensation that is the most obvious, that is asking for your attention the most in this moment. Again, it could be just an itch, it could be just the chair, it could be something more meaningful. Doesn't matter. Whatever you're feeling, just give that your attention. And the feelings might be changing a lot. That's okay. It's like being in a loud room. Your attention will shift from one loud person or distraction to another. That's okay. Just notice what you're feeling. And you're still circular breathing. Complete relaxation on the exhale. And notice where in your body that strongest feeling is located in any given moment. Just notice where it's at in the moment. And when you have a good sense of where that strongest feeling is in that moment, pull your inhale in through that part of your body, just as if that part of your body was permeable to air. So you're inhaling through your strongest feeling, and you're inhaling the feeling itself into your awareness. That's the idea. And as you inhale through the strongest feeling, notice what the feeling feels like. Don't label it in any way or judge it as good or bad. Just feel it for what it is in its raw felt sense. Notice that it in reality is a physical pattern of energy in the body. And just be open and receptive to whatever that feeling has to offer you. And remember, no matter how uncomfortable it feels on the inhale, you get to let it go on the exhale. Every exhale is an opportunity to let go of whatever you're holding on to. So inhale through the strongest feeling, feel it as much as you can, and relax. Inhale through the strongest feeling. Be open to receiving whatever the feeling is. Notice the details and relax. The idea is to tune the feeling in well enough to notice the subtle changes that are already occurring from moment to moment. If you maintain awareness of the strongest feeling, you'll notice that it's always changing subtly from moment to moment to moment. Jim used to say, if you can explore an ordinary feeling in extraordinary detail, you will have an extraordinary experience. So still continue to circular breathe, relax on the exhale. And as you explore the feeling in detail, notice that you can explore it in even more detail. If your attention wanders off into thoughts, no problem. That's okay, happens to everybody, including me. Just gently bring your awareness back to the strongest feeling. If you're getting sleepy, try breathing a little bit faster and fuller for a little while. So as you're inhaling through the strongest feeling, I want you to enjoy this moment as much as you can. Notice that the feeling is at least 1% enjoyable. If it wasn't a little bit enjoyable, that would mean that you were in infinite agony. And I'm pretty sure that you are not in infinite agony because you probably wouldn't even be here. Therefore, you must be enjoying the present moment to some extent. So notice that. Notice that you are already enjoying the present moment to some extent. And just be open to enjoying it even more. The idea is to enjoy it as much as you can. You could even try to double your enjoyment. Just go for it. It seems ridiculous, but try to see if you can double your enjoyment of the present moment. And you can use this as a skill. As you enjoy the moment as much as you can, you'll notice that you can enjoy it even more. Now enjoy it even more than that. Really go for it. Enjoy it basically infinitely. Try to enjoy the present moment infinitely. If you're like most everybody, you find you cannot enjoy the present moment infinitely. There's something there that's preventing you from enjoying it even more. Could be a thought or concern in your mind. Could be some kind of unpleasant pattern of energy, something stuck. That's okay. Whatever that is, try to enjoy that as well. Allow enjoying the present moment as much as you can put you in touch with whatever is there that's limiting your ability to enjoy. And that's the next thing you pay attention to. And then the idea is to enjoy that feeling or sensation as much as you can. And if it's a thought or concern in your mind, notice how you feel about it. Even if your mind is moving a million miles an hour right now, notice what it feels like for your mind to move a million miles an hour or a million kilometers an hour. Even if your mind is very active, there's still feelings going on. And so again, just allow your mind to do what it wants to do. Allow it to go on a vacation, as it were. Just gently bring your awareness back to the strongest feeling in your body. And inhale through that strongest feeling. And relax. And what I'd like you to do now is maybe play with the breathing a little bit. Try changing it up. Let's do some faster and fuller. So we're going to go faster and fuller now. And as you're doing that, see if you can maintain awareness of the strongest feeling. And notice how your perception of feeling changes as you change your breathing. It might improve your perception of it, or it might intensify the feeling in a way you don't like. But just keep breathing fast and full for another 10 seconds. And now we're going to go faster still. Remember to keep the exhale relaxed. The key to going faster is to take in less air. So you're taking in like a burst of air. Just do the best you can. Now take a deep breath. Another deep breath. Relax. And you'll probably notice there's more energy flow. We like to say to feel the tingling of aliveness within the pattern of energy. The key of the breath is to enhance our kinesthetic awareness, to enhance our feeling awareness. By breathing more, we can make a direct, raw, energetic connection, an energetic rapport with the feeling. By breathing, we can see the truth of the feeling, which is that it's just a pattern of energy in the body. Any emotion that comes up, just remember that it is not a verdict about you. It is just a pattern of energy that very much wants your love and attention. So explore the subtle changes in the feeling. Inhale through the strongest feeling. Relax on the exhale. And enjoy this moment as much as you can. Even if the feeling doesn't seem pleasurable, open up to it as though it were. Be open and receptive to the feeling being enjoyable in a new and unusual and unexpected way. Just relax your mind, stay open-minded about it. There's nothing suppressed in anyone except suppressed bliss. So if you feel a new feeling that comes up and it's unpleasant, just remember that it really, in reality, is a unique type of bliss. So the more you can relax in the presence of it, the more you'll become aware of its unique value, its unique wisdom, and its unique style of bliss. Just milk this moment. Milk the feeling for every drop of pleasure you can, even if it's just a little bit. There's nothing wrong with crying or laughing or whatever has to happen. And feel free to play with the breathing rhythm. You can breathe slow and full, or you can breathe fuller and faster, or you can breathe fast and shallow. If the feeling is really unpleasant, you could try breathing really fast. That does take some practice, but it sounds and looks something like this. And then after 10 seconds, take a deep breath. If it's still unpleasant, do a little bit faster and shallower. Yeah. The idea is to explore the details of the feeling, and it doesn't need to be intense. If it's too intense, you can breathe faster and shallower, and that will lower the intensity and allow you to continue to pay attention to the details. And we'll just take a couple more minutes before closing. So just keep circular breathing and relaxing. As you inhale through the strongest feeling, be open and receptive to the feeling, explore in detail and relax. Inhale through the strongest feeling. Tune the feeling in well enough to notice the subtle changes and surrender. Inhale through the strongest feeling and let go. Totally let go. Totally relax. And just breathe in whatever way feels right for you in the moment. There's no wrong way to do this. The fact that you're here at all, doing it at all, means that you are already applying the process perfectly. So let go of trying to do this right. You're doing fine just the way you are. Just try different breathing rhythms. There's no wrong way. You want more energy, you want to feel more connection, breathe faster and fuller. If the feeling already is enjoyable, breathe fuller and slower to really savor it. If the feeling is uncomfortable or unpleasant or painful, breathe faster and shallower for a little while. And while you're doing that, always maintain awareness of the strongest feeling. If your mind drifts off, no problem. Even if it goes off for 10 minutes, that's fine. Notice it and gently bring your awareness back to your strongest feeling. With practice, you'll be able to maintain awareness of your strongest feeling throughout a session. It's like any skill. It gets easier with practice. Continue to inhale through the strongest feeling. Big breath. If you're feeling particularly activated, that means you have some unpleasant stuff coming up. Continue to apply this process even after I've closed. Just continue doing it. Every feeling integrates into joy eventually. And if it doesn't integrate in this session, it will either integrate in a few minutes or it will go back into suppression. You never need to worry about what comes up. If a feeling was going to kill you, it would have done so by now. And just be grateful that the feeling has come up at such an appropriate time. Enjoy it as much as you can. Enjoy this moment as much as you can. And relax. And when you're ready, you can come out. Just take your time, though. A couple, three deep breaths, maybe, before opening your eyes. Maybe wiggle your fingers and toes a little bit. When you're ready, you can open your eyes. I love this stuff. Just breathing it all is amazing, right? Just the fact that you even do it at all, it doesn't have, you don't even have to do it right. Just doing it at all is enjoyable. It's like the moment I start a session, I'm like, all right, this is going to be great. You know, it's just like, it's so much better than not doing it, right? It's so much better to be breathing and relaxing and enjoying a little bit than not at all.
And it's crazy how we're only doing that for 10 minutes there. And yeah. Still a very intense experience, a very valuable experience. It's amazing. Okay. And you can get so much more if you do it for long.
So if you enjoyed that practice, I have done another video with Paul where we go into loads of detail about the history of the practice, how it was created, how he got into it, all that kind of stuff. Really interesting video. I've also left links below to Paul's website. If you want to sign up and do that with him or one of the Vivation teachers, then check those links out. I've also left a link for Jim Leonard's book, Vivation, The Skill of Happiness, which is a great book. Even if you're not necessarily interested in circular breathing techniques, it's just a lot of wisdom in there around acceptance and resistance and things like that. Also, while you're here, do check out my website, drawbreath.com. You can sign up for courses. There's loads of free resources on there as well. I've also written a book called Draw Breath, The Art of Breathing, which recently won 2 literary awards for well-being, creativity, and innovation. It teaches you to meditate by breathing and drawing in time with your breathing. So drawing up on pink lines as you inhale, down on blue lines as you exhale, and you're just tracing these really simple, calming images. So definitely check that out if you're into drawing or meditation. And yeah, if you enjoyed this video, please do give it a like and consider subscribing to the channel, because it really helps the channel, and we're dropping new videos every week now with experts in breathwork and meditation. So I hope to see you again soon.